Well, relatively quick back into the actual game here, or to the title screen at least. Welcome to First Trophy. I'm going to play a PlayStation 2 game. That's always fun to, kind of play a game on a console that didn't have trophies and work toward my first trophy because there was a remaster or whatnot. This is the PS4 version. It is, basically a re-release, I want to say, of the original Jedi Starfighter game on the PS2. But what they've been doing with this kind of thing is they'll make it look decent for 1080p and add
Alpha Target needs protection.
trophies and all that good stuff. So, yeah, I figured let's go with this one for, well, let's go with a PS2 game, and I decided on Jedi Starfighter. It's part of the, it's kind of a cousin of Rogue Squadron, but a little bit different. Yeah, I want to create a game on the memory card 8 MB for PlayStation 2 in memory slot 1. Oh boy. That's how direct it is of a translation. They're not changing much of anything. A deadly plot. Yes, just let me get into the game already. Goodness. Okay. Let's go hit up the options. And okay. Sometimes subtitles are under sound. Code? Oh, they're secret codes. Neat. I'll have to play with that at some point. Save and load game credits. Okay, so nothing about subtitles. Let's just go right to the story missions then. And let's do the training first. Just to be on the safe side. Destroy targets in under 1 minute. Fly through all training rings. Okay. Oh, I
I
actually hit
sense
the
that
button
you
to
are eager
continue.
to test the
Excellent.
abilities of this prototype.
Yes, Master Tim, it
Yes.
is a fascinating ship.
Be patient. I am going to switch you to manual control in a minute, but before I do, I will activate your target tracker so you will be able to find me if you stray too far. You should now see a target tracker on your HUD display. Notice how the
I
target
do,
tracker stays
but I
on my
can't
ship at
steer.
all times. When I fly out of your view, the target
This
tracker
does
will
look
turn to an
really
arrow pointing
nice.
you in the direction to fly to get to my ship. When you are ready, Master Gallia, I will release the autopilot controls.
I'm ready.
Good. Switching to manual control. Try to stay with me.
Now this is more like it.
Since these controls might not be familiar to you, I will review them. Pulling the stick towards you will pitch the nose of the craft up. Pushing the
Yep,
stick
I got
away
it.
from you will pitch the nose of the craft down. Moving the
Standard
stick to the
flight
left or
controls.
right will turn the craft in the corresponding direction. The stick on your right controls your roll. To roll, just push the stick to the right, and the
Okay.
craft will roll right. Pushing the stick to the left will roll left.
I usually
Master
prefer that
Gallia,
on the shoulder
are you paying
buttons, but
attention?
eh.
Of course.
Yes.
Good. Let's put the fighter to the test by flying through a series of rings. When you fly through a ring, you will notice that the next
Oh,
ring will become
interesting.
more visible.
Zoom in.
If you miss a ring, you will have to go back and fly through it. Get ready. We are approaching the first ring now.
Got
I
it.
am removing the tracker from my ship. You will notice that the rings fade out after you have flown through them. Now on to the second ring.
Whoa, hey. What was that about?
Use your braking control to slow the craft. You might notice that your turning rate increases when you are using your brakes. This can come in very handy in battle.
I think I might have accidentally bumped into him earlier. So I was speeding up just to poke at it.
Good. We are halfway there. Use your boost control to speed up your craft. Just as the brake increases your turning ability, boost reduces your turning rate.
Dang it.
You missed that one. Try that one again.
Yeah, I know.
This is the last ring. Well done, Master Gallia.
Did I get less than a minute? I don't think I did.
Laser cannons.
Your senses serve you well.
You got it.
Any longer. Let's head to the shooting range.
Very well. Let's continue.
Ahead of us, there are several test targets for you to shoot. Use this control to fire your lasers. Once you have the target in your sights, fire your lasers to destroy it. I will start timing you from the first target that you destroy. I am sending you the first target to be destroyed. One down. Whenever you destroy a target, your targeting computer will automatically switch to the nearest hostile to your location. Good. Now, get this one. Well done. Good work, Master Gallagher.
There we go.
There are two more targets left. Keep going. You are doing well. You are a natural.
Thank you.
How's that?
It's almost like I've played spaceflight games before.
Now, let's see what you have learned. Are you up for a quick dogfight? First one to knock out the other shields wins.
I thought you'd never ask, Tin.
On my signal, we fight.
Of course, Master Tin.
Begin. Master Gallia, I am waiting. Good. Ah, good hit. You got me.
You talk too much, Stacey.
Your shields are getting low. I almost have you. Good shot.
Master Tin, it looks like your shields are a little low.
Ah, I am beaten.
Gotcha.
You truly are a master.
I've bested the Jedi Council's best pilot. This is quite an honor, Master Tin.
Excellent job, Master Gallia. Switching to autopilot. That concludes today's exercises.
No, not autopilot. Mission success. Ah, hidden objective, huh? Yay! I got the bonus and the hidden objective. Nifty. Yes, let's save. Okay. That went quick. Complete training in under 4 minutes. Destroy all static targets.
We'll power up the prototype starfighter after a quick test of the heads-up display, or HUD.
As you wish, Master Tin.
The primary purpose of your HUD is to inform you of the health of your starfighter. The green line indicates shield health, while the yellow indicates your hull health.
This seems very much like the other ships I have flown, yes.
You'll notice a yellow outline around my ship every time I speak.
Is there
this
a
is
way
the
to...
dialogue tracker.
No. It... Whoops. Didn't want to do that.
Always track the current speaker.
Ah, there we
I
go.
Understand.
The dialogue tracker will outline a speaker's ship when that ship is in view. When the ship is outside your field of vision, the tracker will transform into an arrow. There are two other types of markers. The first one I'll talk about is the target tracker. I am going to lock your target tracker on my craft now. You'll notice that the marker is green.
How about no more talking and let me do stuff?
That indicates that I am a friendly craft.
I know.
The tracker would be red.
I should be patient.
This target marker or reticule shows some information about the craft it is targeting, including bars that show shield and hull strength. As you can see, my ship has full shields and hull strength at this time. I will simulate damage to
at
my
this
ship.
Time.
There. See how the bars on the reticule changed when my shields dropped to half? In battle, this will show you how much damage an enemy or friendly craft has sustained. You will notice that when my ship is targeted, a craft display has appeared on your screen. This display will provide an image of the targeted craft, as well as its name.
Yes, much like all Starfighter targeting displays.
Now that we have familiarized
ourselves, at least she's getting a little, like, saucy about it, too.
The prototype's combat systems, including the zoom control and the cycle targeting control. I am releasing control of your craft now. There is a platform nearby with several targets placed on it. To find them easily, please press the cycle targeting button. Very good. As you approach your target, you should experiment with the zoom control. This lets you focus on faraway targets, allowing you to shoot them for an extended range. Excellent job, Master Gallia. Well done, Master Gallia. Let's try a more difficult test. I'm uploading an objective tracker to your HUD. An objective tracker allows you to keep track of important enemies and allies during a mission.
It lets me track objectives? Amazing!
In order to actually hit a moving target, you should lead it by firing where you think the moving target will be, rather than where
okay,
it is now.
Normally I do practice, appreciate doing training stuff first, but this is overly verbose.
Test, I'm calling in some holographic drones to attack you. Please destroy the target so that we may continue with the test. Remember our earlier lessons about flying the prototype. Brake when you want to turn faster, and boost if you want to escape.
Nice. Boost to get in close, and there we go.
Record time. You know what that means.
I'm sure I did.
Another chance to best you, Master Tin?
Yes, Arty.
More talking? Oh. Come on. Almost got your shields down. What, do I have to actually, like, take down your hull too now? Is this secretly Order 66?
I've beaten you again, Master. Perhaps this prototype is more effective than you believe.
Ooh, it's a prototype craft. Yay, all greens again. Yep, let's keep going. At least saving is fast because of, you know, it not actually being the slow, memory cards from the PS2 era.
What's this all about, Jenkins?
Oh.
I have, made some adjustments on the Havoc and wanted to refamiliarize you with the controls.
You did what?
Okay.
Nothing better be broken on this bird, Jenkins.
Don't worry about it. The first control you should check is bore sight targeting. Using bore sight targeting, you can select any ship as a target by placing your crosshairs near the vehicle in question and then activating the control. We have acquired some vehicles and ordnance from the Trade Federation. We'll use this useless junk for target practice. Nim, please foresight one of these fighters.
I copy.
Well done. The
Got
next
it.
Function you should check is sensor targeting. Sensor targeting is activated when you depress the foresight targeting control and hold it down. Please activate sensor targeting.
Okay.
Excellent. While sensor targeting is activated, any targets that are not in view are indicated by off-screen arrows. The blue ones indicate objective targets. You can use these controls to ferret out large groups of enemies or to find your friends. The next function is called revenge targeting.
Anytime you've been
damaged by yay, revenge targeting. That sounds like fun.
To target that shooter. After a few seconds,
okay.
Its function returns to normal cycle targeting. I'm going to allow a fighter to shoot at you, so you can see revenge targeting.
I'm going to allow a fighter to shoot at you. Come on. Someone's supposed to shoot at me? There we go.
Well done. I have now activated your lasers. When you're tired of experimenting with the target control, feel free to destroy all this refuse. When you're finished with that, I'll teach you about the new wingmate control system.
I'll waste them.
One more to go. This ship's a bit of a beast. Come on. Aha, gotcha. No
now
one left.
That you've finished with this section
good.
Of the mission, please follow me to the next area.
Okay. Oh, I was heading in the right direction after all. Do 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 do. Well, it definitely sounds like Star Wars music.
When fighting larger starships, focus on destroying key components such as turrets. In this test, we'll use your Boresight targeting control to target individual components on a large ship. I've placed an objective target on a Trade Federation lander. When you see it, use Boresight targeting on one of its turrets. You must be in range of the object before the components will register as individual targets. You are now in range. Excellent! I will now unlock the turrets on the lander, and you can have a bit of fun with it.
All right, already.
You can have a bit of fun with it. Okay. Ow. That's not fun. Okay. One more to go.
Now that you've finished with this section of the mission, please follow me to the next area. This final test will demonstrate wingmate commands. Activate your wingmate command display.
Hiya, boss.
With this display activated, you can give commands to wingmates. Notice the display disappears if it is not activated. You won't be able to give orders to your wingmates unless the command display is activated. Keep it activated to communicate with your wingmates.
Okay, makes sense.
Notice the topmost indicator. Using wingmate commands, you can command your wingmates to attack your target. You will now see a series of targets. Have your wingmate attack them.
Only if it'll shut you up.
Thank you. Okay, here we go.
Order your wingmate to attack one of these fighters.
Attacking target.
Excellent. A lightning bolt wingmate command tracker above a ship indicates that your wingmate has been commanded to attack it.
Are you actually gonna hit it, dude? That was pitiful. Do I have to wait until... Thank you. I was just about to do it myself.
Now that you've finished with this section of the mission, please follow me to the next area.
You got it.
Notice the right indicator. Activate it to tell wingmates to protect you. This is your wingmate's default behavior. If you are being attacked, they will do their best to destroy your attacker.
Well, I have to admit, Jenkins, these adjustments will pay off big in battle.
Now what?
Status!
This cargo ship is being attacked by some fighters. Notice the indicator on the left.
Shield this target.
Protecting target.
Use this command to order your wingmen to protect your current target. Target that friendly cargo ship. Have your wingmate protect it.
I copy.
Okay.
your wingmate to protect the freighter.
I did.
Cover my target.
Protecting target.
Excellent. A shield wingmate command tracker above a ship indicates that your wingmate has been commanded to defend it.
Yay, so I don't have to.
Nice job, Bim. Why don't you try your skills on me?
What's that?
Shoot at me, so I can finally get back at you for cheating me in that game of death dice.
Think before you challenge me.
Defeat me if you can.
I'm gonna hand you your head.
Impressive, Bim.
Better luck next time, Jenkins.
Woohoo! Wait, no, no, no! Pull up, pull up, pull up! Okay, good. It took control away from me. Ooh, 656. That was close. Wish I remember how many training mission blocks there were, so I knew how far I was going in this. Okay, destroy static targets, complete training in under 4 minutes.
Jenkins, what's so important that I had to break up my game of death?
Bombing run time.
I merely wish to demonstrate your starfighter's new secondary weapons system.
You've modified my ship again? The last time you did that, it took 6 months to clean the butcher bugs off of my windshield.
Yes, I have modified your ship. Specifically, I've added a new weapon system.
A new weapon system? Well, that's more like it.
Glad to help. Now, let's review how to use these new modifications. While I'm sure you know how to use your lasers, the Havoc can also carry several other secondary weapons, specifically bombs and missiles. The default secondary weapon...
Yeah, see, that's why you press buttons bomblets to figure out what
these
happens.
These bomblets recharge over time, providing an infinite supply. You can fire your secondary weapons using this control. I have set up several targets on the ground here. Follow your objective marker to find each one and destroy it using your bomblets. When using any bomb-related weapon, you will notice that you are shown a new type of aiming sight called a terrain sight. This shows you where a bomb will land at any given time. When using bombs, make sure that the terrain sight is placed over your targets before you fire. As you can see, bombs affect an area around
think
them,
that worked?
So you don't have to be dead on when firing them. But this area effect can also hurt you, so don't get too close to your targets.
Stang! Those are powerful.
Stang!
Look at your craft display. You'll notice an indicator that reveals how many energy bombs you have left. It is wise to keep an eye on this gauge at all times.
Oh, come on. That was right on it. There we go. Woohoo!
As I have mentioned, your ship can carry several types of ammunition. Your craft display shows which ammunition you are currently using. You can choose another form of ammunition by using the secondary weapon selection controls. Using the secondary weapon selection system, please change your ammo from energy bombers to cruise missiles.
Cruise missiles. You got it.
Excellent. As you can see, your aiming sight changes when you choose missiles. This new sight allows you to lock your missiles on enemy targets. To lock a missile on a target, merely place the sight over your target. The sight will then change colors.
Dang,
as your target
that's got range.
Attempts to establish the lock. After a second or so, you will hear a tone indicating that the lock is complete. Once you have locked onto the target, fire your missile and move on to the next target.
You know, this isn't even the first game in the series.
So each one is precious. Use them wisely.
I do like how enthusiastic he is, though. Come on. There we go. I think that's the last target. Because I couldn't hit the button to go to any other ones. Nope, guess not. Come on. Oh, I have to wait for it to recharge. Dang it. Alright, fine. Let's see if I can take it out with these.
Once again, a splendid display of violence, Nim.
Ow.
Remember, once you're on either cruise missiles, you must manually switch back to energy bombs if you wish to continue using a secondary weapon. Ahead, I've arranged for a more challenging test of
your
abilities.
Oh, so I guess the missiles don't recharge.
I have arranged for Quentin to be your wingmate.
Hiya, boss.
I've placed on your HUD an objective marker, indicating a tractor beam tower up ahead. It's guarded by several hostile units. With Quentin helping you, destroy that tower and as many enemy targets as you can.
I love a challenge.
I love it when a plan comes together. Come on.
Great work.
There we go.
We've covered everything. You should be ready to
I think so too.
Trade Federation now.
Did I get that in time? No, I didn't. Oh well. Probably because I messed up with the missiles. I was expecting the missiles to be there, and, like, I had enough missiles to begin with, but I fired one off for fun. Achieve force clarity with all attempts. Ooh, force powers, huh?
Master Gallier, I sense the force flowing through you. Are you prepared to use it?
Yes, I am ever mindful sure. of the force's potential, even while in flight.
Good. Today, we shall practice using the Force in conjunction with your Jedi Starfighter. Before I demonstrate how to use your Force powers, I will show you how to select them. In your craft display, you will notice your Force power selector. This is a projection of your connection to the Force. I will highlight it now. For now, you have two powers to choose from, Force Lightning and Force Shields. You currently have Force Lightning selected. To select a different power, clear your mind and select the power you wish by using the Force Power Selector. Shall we practice this?
I'm clearing my mind as
sure.
we speak.
Very well. Press up on the Force Power Selector. Very good, Master Gallia. This will select Force Shield.
That was quick enough.
When you are ready, please activate your Force Shields. Excellent. Exerting such power does not come without costs. You will no doubt feel the force drain from you momentarily. As a result, you will not be able to use your force powers again until you have rested for a short time. The length of time you must wait is indicated by the meditation timer.
Yeah, I
see
that.
It appears here on your ship's display. When the timer completes, your mind will be relaxed and force powers will again be available.
I see, Master Tim.
Very good. Let us try again. This time, when you focus your mind, press and hold the force activation button.
Okay. I'm doing it.
Like this?
I did it.
Well done, Adigalia. Did okay. you notice the colored particles whirling around your ship? That is the force coalescing
yeah.
around you. This is the same effect you will receive if you quickly tap the force activation button. Sometimes a good tactic if you are in the middle of a heated battle. If you release your power then, your force power will be at normal strength.
Understood.
A Jedi Master can achieve varying levels of success when using the force. As you draw in the force, the coalesce effect will become more concentrated. This is when the force is most powerful around you. If you unleash your power then, you will create a much more potent version of your selected force power.
Indeed.
But be careful, Master Gallia. If you wait too long, you will become strained, and your force power will be quite weak when released.
Very well.
Good. I would like you to try again, and this time, attempt to release the force when it is most potent. You released the Force too late, resulting in a strong
effect. Yeah, I noticed that.
In the future, try to release the Force earlier.
May I try again?
Please do. Remember, you must wait until the meditation timer has completed.
Well, at least this one isn't timed. Okay. Okay. Go. There we are.
Master Gallia.
Yes, I see. How long will my force shields remain active?
The duration is based on the effect you achieve. A potent use of the force will result in a longer duration for your shields. If you time it perfectly, the potent effect for the force shields can last quite a long time. Are you ready to learn?
Yeah, it lasted like three quarters of my recharge time.
Before you do anything, please use your force power selector to select force lightning. Good. Now, force lightning works in conjunction with your normal targeting system.
They're getting out of here before I practice with the force lightning, I see.
Shall I target you now, Master Tin?
No, that will not be necessary. I have procured some training droids for today's exercise.
That is too bad.
Yes. Well, a training droid has been released. Please select it as your target. You are a natural pilot. Now, when you activate Force Lightning, notice that the coalesce effect is centered around the training droid you have targeted. You may use your Force Lightning now, Master Gallia. Be cautious, though. Your Force Lightning will have no effect against larger ships.
Sparkly.
The same is true for buildings.
Thank you for the hint, Master Tin.
You have learned your lessons well. I will release a few more training droids so you might practice your skills on them. Oh, yes.
Okay.
These droids are armed with polar lasers.
Of course they are.
You may commence. Perfect execution, Master Gallia. Force lightning can affect several craft at once, as long as they are within close proximity.
Chain lightning. Nice. Ah. Hey, I thought I was gonna miss that. I should have missed that too.
You timed that one just right. You are a model student.
Yay!
The exercise
I'm a model student.
Is over. You have given me confidence that the prototype will be in good hands.
Thank you, Master Tin.
Thank you, Artigalia.
Mission success. That is really smooth. That's a very nice gradient. Oh, I didn't... Hey, there's my first trophy. I didn't achieve Force Clarity with all attempts, but hey, at least I got a trophy. So the controls are just a little bit weird in that, you know, X is fire instead of R2, but other than that, it made some sense for the game. They are just way too chatty, though. I hope it doesn't carry through the rest of the game to have that much vocalization going on. Otherwise, I had a lot of fun. Probably come back to this.
Well, you should get your chance soon enough. I sense that Master Windu has a new assignment for you.
That's odd. He usually keeps his thoughts well hidden.
He still does, but then I just talked to him, and he wants you to report to the Jedi Council Chamber immediately.
I'm on my way.